Steve Dotto here. Today, a couple of tips on sharing within Evernote. We have so much of our information now stored in Evernote. It would be really useful if we can take that information and share it with others. And Evernote makes it very easy for us to do that now. Now, there's two basic ways that we can share. We can share individual notes, or we can share entire notebooks. And we have multiple options within those two kind of broad areas. Let me show you how it works. I'm in the Evernote desktop application here, and these are all my notebooks open here before us. Now, I might want to share my cooking book, my cooking notebook. That would be a great idea. I wanted to share it with my kids. They're off to university now. They might want my recipes. So rather than having them email me every time they want to know my beer can chicken recipe, I might just keep it in my notebook where I do keep it, and I might just share this entire notebook with them. So if I hover my mouse over my cooking notebook, we've got this little pop-out here that allows me to open the sharing menu. Now, I've got a few different options as I go through each stage of this. The first option I have is I can share this with individuals, or I can create something called a public link. A public link will create a URL that I can put into an email or put on my website that people can click on, and anybody from the public can then go in and view my notebook. That's a little bit of oversharing as far as I'm concerned in this particular case. I just want to invite individuals. So when I click on that, I can now enter the email address of my son and daughter and allow them to be able to share and edit this notebook. Actually, share this notebook. They can't edit this notebook yet. If I have the premium version of Evernote, they can edit the notes and edit the notebook, but in the basic version, they can just share and see the notes. Now, you do want to be careful if you are a premium user, allowing people to edit notes within your notebook. It can cause some confusion, so you really have to make sure you have control over the situation. If you want to work on collaborative documents, while this is an option, I think that using a tool like Google Docs, the Google Drive word processor, is a little bit more is a little better for business and a little better for workflow because it does such a good job of tracking all of your changes. But I digress. We're talking about sharing within Evernote here, so let's get back to it. You can choose here to invite the individuals, and you can allow them to view the notes or view the notes and activity, and you can add a little message. When you do this, they will be sent an email inviting them to log into the notebook and to be able to add it to their Evernote collection. And let me show you what happens at that point, because I actually have a shared notebook here that I share with one of the people that does a regular feature on my radio show. Now, what he does is Rick sends me his notes before we go on air. And I've got all of the different notes for the different things that I'm going to be talking about. And I don't have to root through my old emails to find all of the attachments of what the notes are that he's going to be talking about. Instead, as he's gathering his notes, he just shares this notebook with me, so I'm better able to interview him when we actually do the recording of the radio show. Terrific use of shared notebooks. Now, on a little more detail, you can go on and you can actually share individual notes. Let me open up all of my notes here. There we go. And let's say that I just want to share one individual note. When you open the note, yep, it pops in the note window. Here in the right-hand side at the very top, you have a sharing tool where you click on it and it pops out the option to share, to post this to Facebook, to post it to Twitter, to email the note, or to copy the URL to the clipboard. That gives me, again, a link that I can embed in an email that people can click on to get to this one note. If I click on that, what it does is it enables sharing for this one individual note. So it actually goes through and goes into my settings and modifies my settings to allow me to share this one note. If you just want to share a document for a short period of time and then you want to retract that sharing, you don't want to share it after that period of time, you just go into the note area here, click on the share button, note settings, and there you can choose to stop sharing that note. Actually, it's worth popping back into that menu for a moment, because in the share menu, we have the same options as we had within the pop-out in the upper right-hand side there. Now, as I said, this is in the desktop application. As is often the case with Evernote, we have much of the same functionality in the web browser version. Now, I have my Chrome browser open up here. I have a note opened up here. And if we look here in the right-hand side, we have the exact same options, being able to email and share this note from the web browser version as well. Evernote does a great job of sharing, of storing all of our documents, and now allowing us to share them with others should they need them. I hope you found this little video useful today. If you have, please give us a click a like for us. And if you want to, of course, we really appreciate it if you will subscribe to all of the Dotto Tech videos. We produce about one a week, and we love to have you watching. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.